Hi everybody, it's Julie. Welcome to Hello Monday. Today I'm playing with neon. I know, get your sunglasses because this is so bright. I was actually inspired by a gorgeous neon pastel blanket on Pinterest and I wanted to mimic the look. I'm obsessed with this blanket. So anyway, I had to translate it into a card. And I'm gonna take a piece of watercolor paper that I've cut down to 4 inches by 5 1/4. It's gonna get layered onto a base card. And I'm just going to go ahead and tape it down. I'm masking off the edges because I wanted to have a border going around my piece here. So I'm using washi tape. You could use painter's tape, but I find that I have lots of washi tape, and particularly the colors I'm not fond of and don't ever use on projects, I use them for utilitarian things like this. So it's gonna hold that piece of watercolor paper down to the clipboard and it will help it dry flat. And it will also mask off those edges so that I can do my watercolor work and keep a border around the edges. So I've taken my Hero Arts neon sprays. I love these vibrant colors. I've been having so much fun, and I wasn't into neon originally, but now it's just kind of like I'm totally hooked. And I think I just kind of had to find what I really liked about working with neon before it finally kind of caught hold of me. So I'm gonna take the colors and I put a little bit of drops of the neon sprays. I like them the best for this particular technique for watercolor. Do not try to use ink, the Hero Arts neon ink pads pressed against an acrylic block and then diluting it down. That ink does not have enough viscosity, I guess is the word for it. You're gonna have much better results if you use the neon sprays. So I'm fanning this with a piece of cardstock because I wanted it to dry quickly before I moved on to the next stripe. You really want to have the colors dry in between, otherwise you're going to get quite a bit of bleed through, which is fine if that's what you want, but I didn't want that effect. I wanted to have very definite stripes. And even if I had a little overlap, I didn't want a lot of bleeding to go on. So I had to let each stripe dry in between, and I fanned it with a piece of cardstock because I noticed that if I took my heat gun and tried to speed it up with my heat gun, it kind of faded out the whole neon effect of the colors, and I wanted to preserve that. So air drying is really the best. And if you're impatient like me, then take a piece of cardstock and kind of fan it to get it to dry a little faster. Now, I noticed if I worked quickly, if I had too much color on there and I wanted to dilute it, I could rinse my brush out and then tap it against my paper towel to kind of dry it out a little bit, and then brush across it again to try to diffuse the color. But then I reached a point where I had to stop, and it's like, okay, you gotta stop and let it sit. So I walked away and I found some other things to do, and then I came back when it was all dry. And here's where the magic happens. When you start to peel away the washi tape, you see your beautiful border all around the edges. And the trick with the washi tape is don't pull it off fast or straight up. Pull it kind of laterally and slowly, and then you won't tear your paper. But I was like, yes, this is awesome. I love how it looks. And then I'm gonna border it with a fine tip black marker just to kind of give it a little bit of emphasis and really draw the eye in towards these colors. And not that you really need that because they're pretty eye-catching, but I just felt it just added a nice design element to the panel. And then I'm going to mount this onto a piece of Juicy Pear Basil card shop. I love the heavy weight of this card stock, and I decided not to go with a neon card base because I wanted it to kind of be a little more subdued and let that watercolor panel really pop and catch the eye and not distract from it. So now I'm gonna take a die cut. This is a really fun Hello die by Avery L, and I just love it because the letters are a little bit chunkier, and I can do this effect where I add the glossy accents, and I'm going to do that in a minute, but first I need to get this glued onto my panel. So I'm going to take some Mono Multi and I just laid it face down on a piece of the Post-it tape to hold it temporarily in place while I'm working on it so it doesn't get away from me while I'm trying to get some glue there on the back of it. You can use glossy accents if you wanted to as an adhesive, but I don't have one of those really fine tip glue applicators, so I just did it this way. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and press that down into place and kind of get that Post-it tape up off there. It has a really good hold, so it's kind of lifting it up there. So now once we have that lifted off, we can go ahead and start burnishing it down. I just use some wax paper for that so that I don't accidentally get glue or adhesive oozing out onto my fingers and everything. And I'm gonna further embellish this with a few of these lily white doodlebug sprinkles. I just love these enamel dots. They are so much fun, and they're so modern and hip. So I noticed I was out of the medium ones. So all I have are the large ones and the small ones. And I was sitting there thinking, like, is this still gonna create the look I want? And yes, it is. I'm just being too picky. So here we go. I'm gonna go ahead and finish mounting those. And I just used three because I love, you know, that odd number kind of creates a visually pleasing effect. And then as the last step, I'm gonna go ahead and coat the black die cut there with a really heavy layer of glossy accents. And this is going to go on a little bit cloudy, but it will dry crystal clear. And then I have to let it sit and dry completely. And I actually added a second layer to it to get it really super thick. And then I also had another panel that I experimented on. This is half of a quarter sheet that I had practiced a little bit of the watercoloring with the neon colors. And then I edged it there with the orange neon ink pad just to kind of give the edges, the very edges, a neon effect. And you'll see how it looks here in a second. But I'm going to mount that to a very neutral card base. This is taffy. This is one of my favorite colors of Basil cardshop paper. And then I'll go ahead and do the same thing. I'm going to mount this hello die. This time I went ahead and die cut it in white. I felt it looked really nice with the softer neon here. And I'm just going to mount it in place just the same way I did the black one on the other card. Get that burnished down. And then I just wanted to tilt it so you could see the effect of what it looks like with that orange neon ink pad pressed against just the edges there. It's a really cool effect. Now you probably couldn't see it on camera because I didn't pick it up, but I got a little bit of dirt smudged on my white die cut, so I wanted to disguise it. I didn't want to have to start all over on the card, so I took some white enamel accents. This is kind of like glossy accent, but it's white. And went over that the letters to keep them nice and bright white. And here you can see I adjusted the exposure on my camera. I'd been having trouble with my camera getting a really good look there at the neon colors. And here's the pastel with the pretty orange edging. And here's the one on the right with the bolder, more bright, intense colors. And I just loved how these turned out. They very much remind me of the blanket I saw on Pinterest. Thanks for watching.